subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello, welcome to my channel Kritika Entertainment. Today I will tell you how to connect multiple clients with single server. So for that you have to learn what either multiprocess by using fork function, otherwise you have to use the IO multiplexing. Now all these videos I have given except the IO multiplexing. Now I will tell you what is IO multiplexing. IO multiplexing means, suppose there are IO multiplexing uses IO multiplexing, there are number of FDs are we are using in IO multiplexing, and select is a system call API that will be what choose among the FD which FD is ready for read or write or exception from the select function. That means when select function is used to pass the number of FDs into that, then select function returns which FDs are used for read the data or write the data into socket, or what which FDs are used for exception, generate the exception. So all the so we generally use the read FD. Read FD means select function returns number of FDs which are ready to read the data from either socket or from file or from networking. So now I'll tell you about the select API. So what will happen first, suppose this is the FD. Suppose there are three FDs are defined. Suppose this is called your read FD, and this is called write FD. Write FD, this is called exception FD. Exception FD. Okay. Suppose in read FD, we have what? Suppose number of FDs we have used for read FD, suppose that is called 1, 3, 5 and 7. But in write FD we are using suppose 2, 4, 6 and suppose 8. Then what will happen here? Now these FDs are used to read the data from the what either socket or from file, and these FDs are used to write the data into socket. So we are not using write FD and exception FD, we give the emphasis on read FD. So to create a FD set, there is a data type is called what FD underscore set. That means it is the set of FD which are, it is a data type which is used to declare the number of FD sets. So FD set, I suppose here write the variable read FD. Okay, then what will happen? FD underscore set is a data type and read FD is a variable which can store number of FDs. And okay, then this is a FD set and this is a read FD set. That means in read FD set, this is a read FD set, and read FD set, suppose the number of FDs we have to add it. Then I want to tell you there are generally we are using when you are creating socket API, when you are creating socket function, it returns what 3. Then why it returns the 3 from the suppose every suppose sock FD. Shakam. It is interesting. Now, why it is 3? First is 0. 0 is for what? STDIN. That means standard input. 1 is for standard output. And 2 is for error. And except these 3 predefined, then another FD is written by the socket. So, the next serial is the 3. 3 means it is written by the your socket function. Okay, it is written by the socket function. Then your 3 is the what written from the socket function. So, it is an FD which is used to read return the value from socket function. Achha. Then what will then next is what? Suppose we are using accept function. Accept function means what? Then I have to tell you, if you have doubt what is socket, what is accept, because IO multiplexing is the advanced topic. If you don't know about what is socket, what is accept function, then you I have given a TCP programming for beginners, then you can check from my description list. Then let it then action function. Then when you call the action function, it will return the what? Now your 4. When you call the action function, it returns the one new FD that is called 4. Suppose this is the read FD. Read FD means what? Now it is a FD set, and here some FDs we have added, as 1, 3, 5, 7. Then what will happen? These FDs may be read data from the socket, or may be read what connection request from the client. So then what will do here? I'll tell you. Suppose then in the FD set there are number of what macros are defined. First is FD FD underscore your is what now 0 FD underscore 0. Second is FD underscore 0 FD CLR. Third is FD underscore set. Four is FD underscore is set. These 4 macro we have used. Then all it is also called the function. First is why we use the FD0. FD0 means what? You remember one thing here, when we use the FD, and that means it is store 2 number, 2 bits, either 0 or 1. 0 means what? FDs are off. That means it has no capability to read the data. If you use the 1, that means these FDs can read the data from the socket or from the accept function. So here what will do? Now first time when I declare the FD, that time we need to what? Now we need to all FDs make 0 bit. So that how to do this? Now for do this, what will do here? How to make it 0? Now suppose here I will declare FD underscore set, suppose read FD. Read FD. Then what to write? Suppose I have declared here hash define STDIN suppose 0. Then STDIN 0, that means STDIN is the standard input, but here I have taken the 0, that is called what? User defined value. Suppose user defined value STDIN, actually it is in small letter in C supports, but here I have taken the capital letter, and what is the value? It is 0. 0 means I have taken here, it is the FD. FD defined by me, which is for standard input. Okay, then this is the zero. Suppose zero. Now this is the FD set, and till now I have not decided that it is a read FD or write FD. But in program I have written STDIN, means that means it is a read FD. That means it will read the data from the keyboard STDIN. Okay, then this zero is the what na FD. Then I will be change or I will be first time off this FD so that it is not capable to read the data from the keyboard. So which function I'll be call FD zero, I'll be call it. Okay, then what will write here? FD underscore zero. Okay, FD underscore zero. What will be write here? Now you will be write ampersand read FD. Okay, ampersand read FD. That means when I call this function, I will be again write this. What will do here? Again, I'll be write this. Suppose here four macros I have to call it. FD clear. Second is FD zero. Then third is FD set. Four is FD is set. Okay. Then first, when we declare the FD, then that means first initially we have to assign the zero. Then suppose here I have declared, suppose has define, okay, then stdin, suppose what zero. Then I will declare the FD underscore set, okay, FD underscore set, then I'll be declare the read FD. Okay, that means when you declare FD underscore set read FD in the buffer, it will be create a set. Okay, and that will be hold the all the FD, that is the read the data from the socket or file or keyboard. So then I will be block, I'll be make it zero. So that whenever other FD will be come and it can be stored here. So what will write here? Now for initialize this zero, I'll be write what FD underscore zero, then ampersand read it. Okay, that means after call this function, then read FD set will be what now zero. All these sets will be zero. Then after what will happen? Now here I have declared stdin 0. So now this stdin is written stdin, but till now it is not yet decided whether it will be added in read FD or write FD. But I will be read the data from the keyboard, so it will be added in which FD? Read FD. So what will write here? Now FD FD set. Okay, then what to write? Now you can write also zero or stdin. Okay, then all right, ampersand read it. Or I can write FD set. Okay, stdin. What to write here? Ampersand read FD. Okay, that means I set this FD in which FD set? Now read FD set. That means here what will be stored here? Now your STDIN, STDIN, that means your particular value is replaced. This value is the, actually I have declared 0, so here will be store 0 empty. Okay, that means it will be stored in here 0 empty. Okay, then I think you have understood. That means when I declare the FD set, first time this FD set make the 0. So how to 0? Now you will be call the FD underscore 0, then upper ID. That means this read FD set will be 0. All bits will be 0. Then FD set, this STDIN, that means standard input, I will be written ampersand read FD, STDIN upper ID. That means this STDIN is a FD which value is 0, I have added here. Okay, then after I will be pass all these things inside the where, now select function. Then what is the prototype of select function? I'll tell you. Suppose here will write the select. In select, how many numbers of argument will be passed? Suppose 1 2 3 4 5 number arguments we have to pass. First is the what? Na number of FD. This is the number of FD. Number of FD. Number of FD plus 1. That means our number of FD is what? Na 0. 0. So 0 plus 1 means it will be. That means it will be number of FD. What are the number of FD plus 1? That means here will pass the maximum number of FDs. Okay, list. Maximum number of FD list. Then second is the what? It is the for will be this contains the 3 FDs. What are these FDs? I have told you read FD and write FD and exception FD. So here we write the ampersand read FD. Okay. Then this we have not used to, I have told you several times that we have not used to write FD and exception FD. So these things we have put the null. We have to only read the data from the keyboard. So what is this? This is the used up for time. Time means what? Now how much time it will be wait to for read the data from the keyboard. We will be specify the time. After that time, if you will not found any input, then time will be out. So how to define the time? So you will be define the time this time. Suppose struct here will define this time. Suppose struct time val TV. Okay, suppose time val suppose TM. Okay, then TM dot TB underscore second is equal to what is suppose 4, that means 4 second, and TM dot TB underscore U second, that means microseconds. Suppose I have to 5 microseconds. So 1 2 3 4 5 6, that means 5 microseconds. Okay, then what is the value of TM? TM is the 4 second 5 microseconds. So in the null function here will pass the ampersand what? TM. Okay, that means your select function will be wait to check how many number of FDs are active to read the data. So that means select function returns number of FD that are capable to read the data in the program. So then your select function returns there are 3 types of value. Okay, your select function returns, again I want to tell you one thing here also. You can pass the 0 and also null. Null means it will be wait till input is given. It will be wait till input is given. Input it will be not return until unless you given the input. So and zero means it is immediate return. And ampersand TM means it will be wait for specific period of times. Okay. Then what will be happen here? Suppose here it will be 5 seconds. Acha. Then select function returns three types of value. First is what? -1. Second is 0. Third is the positive value. Positive not it is positive. Metric means it will be check ready to read data. Okay. Then 0 -1 0 positive. Then when -1 will be returned, if select function returns the occur the if select function returns the what error, that means -1 will be returned, that means select function is not successfully executed. So that is -1. 0 means what? Now if your time at is occur, suppose I have specified here 4 minutes 5 microseconds in 4.5 microseconds, if input is not given, then your select function returns the 0. Okay. If in specific period time if you have not given any input, then what? Now your select function returns the 0. Acha. Then if any data is come from the what, either keyboard input or from socket or from file, then your that FD returns the select function. Okay. So okay, then that is called a select function. So then it returns the select function. So now I'll be write a simple program in the copy, then after I'll be do in my laptop. Okay, then you see I'll be write a simple program. Suppose first what to write has include stdio.h, then has include stdlib.h, then has include sys socket.h, then for time purpose sys times dot h. Okay, these four header files you have to use. Okay, then you see I'll write the program. Suppose here write the int what main. My program aim is what? I'll be IO multiplexing. That IO multiplexing means what? Now more than one socket will be written from the select function, and it will be check which FD are used to read the data from the what select function. So here I'll be write int main, then what will do? Now you will bracket loop start. Then first I will be declare char suppose ch is the variable to take the input. Before that I have declared has include, okay, then stdin. Okay, stdin, suppose here I have taken the value is 0, that means stdin is a variable which value is 0. It is 0 means it is, I have defined the FD. In my thought it is the FD, 0 FD I have taken, and stdin. Okay, then I can use also stdin or also n0. So then I will be declare one FD set. FD underscore set is a data type. Then I will be declare read FD. That means after declare this line in memory, what will be happen? Now it will create a one set, and that a set name is what? Now read FD. Okay. Then I want to make all these rooms to be zero. So what will be write here? Will be write here what? Now FD underscore zero. Okay, FD underscore zero. What to write here? Ampersand read FD. That means is all these things will be here zero. Okay. Then what will do? Now I'll be add this FD. I'll be add this FD into the read FD set. So because I don't know whether it is read FD or write FD, after adding to this read FD, that means it will be my read. It will be named as my read FD. So what will write here? Now FD underscore set. Okay, FD underscore set. What will write here? Now std in ampersand read FD. Okay, I have written. So then what will write here? Now then after you will be write select. Okay, then here write the select. Suppose int ret. What do you write? Now here we pass maximum number of FD plus 1. What is my number of FD? Number of FD is the my what? Now 0. That means you here you can pass the 1. That means 0 plus 1 is 1. That means it will search from 0 to up to maximum FD. It will maximum FD. Okay, then 1. Then what will pass? The first argument is the read FD. Okay. Then next argument, I have passed the null. For write FD we have not used, and write FD we have not used. Here we pass the what? Ampersand time management. Time. So here I have used the time. So here you have to define the time. What I have to declare? Now suppose I will call this. First I have to declare the time. So what will declare? Now struct time val. Suppose you declare the what? Tm. Okay, then tm dot tv dot underscore second is equal to suppose 5 second. Okay, then tm dot tv underscore u second is equal to suppose 5000 this is 5 millisecond. Okay, then what will write here? Now you will write int return is equal to what will write? Select here pass the number of FD plus 1. What is number of FD? 0 plus 1. That means 1. And you will write the read FD, and you will take the null for write in actual null and ampersand. What will you pass here? TM. Okay, ampersand TM. Then what will happen here? Will write if return is equal to 0. That means print p error select error. Okay, then what will write if return equal to minus 1. If return equal to minus 1, then select. If return equals to 0, that means in specific period of time, this period of time, no one has given the input, then timeout will be occur. So he will write what? Now printf timeout occur. That means your time has passed away. So else will be start curly bracket and will be here ending the curly bracket. So here what will write here? Now you will be check that if minus 1 means error, 0 means error. If minus 1 is not written and 0 is not written, that means it may be there is some FD which are used to read the data from the any source. So here you write what? If FD underscore is set will be checked. That means what? What are the FD? Suppose you write the suppose 0. Okay. Then ampersand read FD. Okay. Ampersand read FD. Okay. That means we'll check 0 whether will be what? Ready to read the data from read FD. FD is set. That means 0 is, that means what? Minus 1 means error. 0 means time had occur. If these two conditions are failed, then there may be some data is waiting from read from the source. So FD is set will be checked that 0 is there 0 in the FD set to read the data. Okay, then if FD set is at 0 and you read FD, then what will write here? If these things are occur, then we will write here the scanf what percentage C ampersand CH. Okay, then scan a percentage ampersand CH, then you will write printf percentage C, then CH. Okay, then bracket will be closed. Okay, then if it will be minus 1, that means it returns the error. If 0 means time had occurred, specific period of time, no input is not given, and FD set will check what? Suppose each FD we have to check from the list that there may be come some data. So if there are many FDs are there, then we can also write FD set 0, FD set 1, FD set 2. That means in else condition, we have to check each FD that 0 FD is inside the read FD. And if FD underscore is set, if 0 FD is setted inside the read FD, if it is setted yes, then data may be come. So scan a percentage upon a CH percentage. Then what will happen? After read the data, we should be what clear this FD. Then to clear this FD, what will be the right here? Now to clear this FD, that means suppose this is the FD set, okay, and this is the FD set. So in FD set, suppose I have told you here which FD set is stored, STDIN. Now I want to remove this FD from the this FD set. Okay, then I want to remove this FD from this FD set, and what will write here? Now after finish of the program, we'll be write FD CLR. Okay, FD CLR, what will write here? Now STDIN or 0, what will write here? Ampersand read FD. Okay, that means now this FD is removed from this FD set. Okay, then it will be removed. Okay, I have used four functions: FD clear, FD set, FD set, and FD 0. Okay, then next is what? There is another also, FD underscore set size. If you don't know how many FDs are there, then you can write also in the select function what? Now FD underscore set size, that means it automatically return the number of maximum FDs. Okay, then what is the advantages of this by using select function? That means I have told you, and these programs I will be also write, I will be create a video of all these advantages in my channel. So first advantage is what? In network programming, there is no guarantee that when data will be come. So there are number of blocking API are there. That blocking means it will be not return unless until it get the data from the source. So what are the blocking API, sorry, blocking APIs are there, blocking accept and receive. These two will be wait until it get the input. So if these functions you have called, then if input is not given from another source, then it will be wait. You may be wait for long time. So what will do select function? Select function is specify the number of time milliseconds, number of millisecond. That means if within that millisecond, if input is not given, then your program refresh again and timeout will be occur and then again try to read from the source. That means it don't wait for the all FDs whether they are capable of read or not. So it will be repeatedly what change they are what it will be repeatedly refresh the program and wait for input or check for the input so that it will never wait your program to the hang mode. That means your program will not be halt because if input is not come from the other source, your program will be timeout. First advantage. Second advantage is what? Now, if you are using, if it will be used to read the from the multiple socket means what? There are, suppose we are using two sockets. First one is FDP, second is TCP. That means you don't know from which socket your data will be come, whether it is UDP or it is TCP. That time we use the IO multiplexing. That means when TCP data will come, it can be read the data from the TCP, or when UDP data will come, it will also read the data from the UDP. So that means it is used when you declare the multiple socket. Third is what? It is used to read the from multiple descriptor. Multiple descriptor means what? Suppose I have taken the two descriptor. First is for read the data from the keyboard or read the data from the socket. That time if you not given the input from the then that means that time what your program is waiting input from the either socket or from the keyboard. That time we can use IO multiplexing from read the data from two sources. That means the one socket FD is used to read the data from file, another socket FD is used to read the data from the socket. So when we declare multiple socket FD, that time also use the which program? Now your IO multiplexing. And next one is what? Now if you are actually your server contains two FD. First one is server FD, second is client FD. If there are number of clients get connected to the server, that time to handle multiple descriptors FD, then we use the IO multiplexing. IO multiplexing what will do? It will be take the all FD and store into select function, and it will return which FD are used to ready for read the data from the source. So these are the benefited from the by using